I was on some panel, a UK Treasury panel to do with high-frequency trading. Now, I'm very anti-high-frequency trading. And I was at various meetings with Treasury economists. And they, after a while, I stopped getting emails and being invited to meetings. This is very strange. Anyway, I had other things to do, so I didn't follow it up. And then I was speaking to a journalist, and he said, oh, yes, all the anti high-frequency trading people on the panel have been quietly dropped because they want the outcome that, oh, high-frequency trading is fantastic, which I wouldn't have said. So there are lots of problems with the people at the top, I think. I also think there's a problem with just the concept of economics. I think of economics as sort of a disorder on the autistic spectrum, if you like. And there are lots of economists around me here. But what I mean by that is that people on the autistic spectrum, they sort of don't have an understanding of an intuitive understanding of how the world works, which is very much what we see of economists. And people on the autistic spectrum, as opposed to what they call NTs or neurotypicals, they create their own internal models of how the world works. And they're never, of course, all the time, they're finding things go wrong, and they have to readjust, they get very upset and angry and whatnot. And
was it Ronald Reagan who defined an economist as someone who sees something working and explains why it's theoretically impossible? Is that
right? No, that's not the same thing at all. I don't think economists see things. They don't look around them. They don't get the experience from the real world is the problem. They just in a little bubble. But they do have their own internal models, and when they're talking amongst themselves, they have this way that they think the world should work, and every now and then things go wrong, and they get very confused, and they have to change their models. So the analogy is pretty good, I think.
So how on earth do we make sense of the world then? Just don't? Do we just grow potatoes and hope for the best? Or?
No, I think if people had more experience of, for example, if you got rid of all economists or forced every economist to start their own business and see how well they got on, that would be useful. Rather than just, and the same goes for MBAs, I don't really see the point of an MBA. When did you start your first business, Roy?
13.
13, exactly, and that's how it should be. We should all learn from people like Roy.